Hello and welcome to Bounds. My name is Whisperfire, and guess what? I've been doing a lot of work around the base, and I found this huge, huge marble deposit, and it was right under my nose. All of this here was marble. I am not done getting all of this marble up, but if I can find my way out, I'll show you where it is. Basically, it's right here. I was flattening the land. I went through a lot of tools, and I have restocked our supply of marble, and I cleared out the two wood farms that I had planted, and I have replenished our supply of wood. Check it out. So we got all of our wood, we got it restocked, and our marble, we got that restocked. And I have been on for about 3.5 hours now today. So I have been doing quite a bit. So I have been looking through the JEI, and I have been grinding up a few materials because eventually I want to go out to the Mesa. That's the closest biome that has some of the items that we need. So I got all of this tanned leather. I shared a couple of creepers, combined it with an iron ingot and a stoked crucible, and we got four diamond ingots, my bad. So let's go ahead and get on with some of the crafting. One thing that I've actually been wanting to do, so let me go ahead and take care of it while I'm thinking about it. And it's actually finally using the crushing tub and these barrels. So what I was thinking was taking these barrels, placing them here, and I have 16 of them. So this is just for a temporary spot, just to place our barrels and these drying basins, because I want to get into some winemaking and processing some of our ore berries. Now, I'm bouncing all over the place because I'm going back to when I want to go off on an adventure. I found these in JEI. They are rocket pants. Apparently, if you wear them while wearing gunpowder, you can jump higher up in the air and actually do some traveling. And also, oh, I'll just use this crafting table. We take these spindles and we make a couple of bolts of tanned leather. So let's go ahead and take that down. And you see this hang glider? I want to make a hang glider. So we'll go ahead, save these spindles, and we'll put them here. Okay, and we put these here, and I'll put the clock away. Now, there's one little thing that I wanted to do. I took the iron armor and combined it with four gold nuggets to get gilded armor. So it's G-U-I? No. Okay, chest. This gilded chest plate. And it's basically, you take each iron armor piece and you place it with these nuggets. And to make the jeweled armor set, we need diamond nuggets, but we need more diamonds. So let's go ahead and take those diamond ingots that we got. Now, where did I put the sticks? Where did I put the sticks? Did I put the sticks here or here? I put the sticks somewhere. Ah, heck with it. We will go ahead and make some more sticks because I want to make a diamond pickaxe. So, we got ourselves a diamond pickaxe. And, we accomplished a quest. Okay, let's go ahead and hit our quest book. I think this would be under spelunking. Okay, so we got the iron pickaxe, so we get 10 experience levels. I haven't claimed any of these. And the diamond pickaxe, we get 20 levels. Okay, so what's next? A refined pickaxe. I will have to take a look at that. But let's go back. What's this? Hammers. Hammer crafting table. I will have to look into that if I keep hitting the wrong button. And better with mods. We did quite a bit yesterday, or last episode. We got the Age of Wood Tier 2. We got all of these items, so we get 6 potion bags. And then we did the automation and basic alchemy. So we got some of the hibachi and the soul sand and all that. So we got some book bags. And we got fire mastery. So we got that, and we got the water wheel, we got the tool turntable, we got the glue, we get an ore bag and a tool bag. Okay, and what else did we want to do? Let's see, rocket pants. Oh, I need 8 gunpowder. I don't have 8, I have 2. Okay, so let's go ahead and check out our loot. So these are the potion bags. And I got 1 gunpowder. Night vision, harming, ouch. Weakness, slowness, regen. Okay, what about these book bags? All right, we got an ordinary book. We got fire aspect 2, magic missile? Magic missile, huh. And we have a spell scroll. Okay, did we right click on it? What do we do with this spell scroll? Enchantments, just enough resources. I'm not too sure. That is something I will need to take a look at. But let's check out our tool bag. And wow, a fishing rod. Whoopee! Fishing rod. Okay, ore bag. Come on, give me something good. Give me something good. I want something good. Okay, let's see. Ooh, diamond. We got ourselves another diamond. Coal, lapis. Okay, so let's see. Let's go ahead. We'll go ahead and just dump it in here. Okay, and this chest is full. And that chest is full. And this chest is full. We need to improve our storage. Okay, we got this dark oak chest. We'll go ahead and dump the rest of this stuff in here. Okay, so we'll just dump that in there. Let's go ahead and grab some diamonds. I saw some diamonds in the nether, but we needed obsidian level tools. So let's go ahead and take care of that. Honestly, I don't know if we're going to do any traveling or exploring today. It depends on if we get everything done in time. We may have to save that for next episode. I'm not too sure. Okay. Okay. So this is the nether, as you may know. Crap. Okay, here's my tunnel. Okay. And here are the diamond ore. Okay. We got some of that. This is what I've been saving for. Oh yeah, wow, this is a big deposit. Okay, let's continue down. This is the tunnel I built that went all the way to the stronghold. Well, not the stronghold, the nether fortress. And it's quite a long tunnel. So we'll just go ahead and run down here because I remember uncovering more diamond ore and emerald ore. So here it is. I've been wanting to get my hands on you guys. Oh yeah. Okay, and there's more. There's more down here. Okay, here's some emerald. Oh, this feels good getting this stuff. Okay, and okay. We got that. We're not done yet. We got 9 diamond ore. Okay, now there is an opening over here. And this is some more diamond ore that I uncovered. Alright, trying to stay away from the pigmen. because I don't want them to aggro me. They tend to aggro when you get in their face. Yeah, they're kind of particular like that. Okay, and let's get you. And that it? Yeah, that's it. Alright, and there was... What's that? Okay. Boy. Pigmen alert. Oh, right. There's some more down there, but, I don't have my armor with me. Let's take a look. Hit you. And we use the pulvis. Okay, and this? The pulvis. And, okay. Okay. And, ouch. Oh boy, we got a blaze rod. Okay. Ooh. Some of the dead, you know, and how they scatter, they kind of clip, you know, they kind of clip. Should have thought about wearing my armor. That was a big derp on my part. Now, if memory serves, I don't think there's anything more down there. Down there is just the nether fortress, but hopefully we ran out of render distance. So, let's go ahead and race on back. Please don't be there. Okay, the coast is clear. Alright, so we'll go ahead and hit run. There's no speed penalty like when you're running on grass or anything like that. And we'll go ahead put these in the pulvis. And then we can upgrade our armor to jeweled armor. And then we'll get on to the brewcrafting, because I want to get those iron berries to get more iron, because I am actually running rather low on iron. I actually need to do more mining. Okay. Coast is clear. Whoa! Okay. Okay. No, no, no. Ouch! Owie! And it's nighttime. Okay. Got the... Okay, my sword is about dead. Okay. And... Oh, come on. Don't break on me, sword. Okay. Do I see any creepers? I am always, always on the lookout for creepers. Because they are so useful. We need to shear them, which I like to call neutering them, because they look like they've been neutered. Shear creepers, they have like tears down the side of their face. And it's so funny because they run into you and they're like, eh, eh. You, come on. My sword is just about broken. Okay. Let's sleep, because creepers don't disappear in the sunlight. Alright, let's take a look. Hi, creeper. You are just what I'm looking for. You right-click with the shears. Their tooltip changes, and they're now a sheared creeper. Alright. But, take a look. Mwah! 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 I love you, sheared creeper. I love you. Aw, you got no horribles? Aw, imagine that. You got no horribles. I'll take your gunpowder. Alright, and these are the creeper oysters. They look like creeper horribles. Don't ask. That's what they look like to me. So that's why I say you neuter creepers. So we'll go ahead and put those in there. And let's see. We'll go ahead and put the netherrack. Yeah. Okay, so we'll go ahead and share that. Now, I got a nice collection of honeycomb, so we can make honey, and that we can make mead, and iron ore berries. I went and harvested all of those trees, and grapes. We can make wine. Okay, so I dumped a few things in here. Yeah, and let's see. I actually... Since our sword broke, let's upgrade our weapon. Now, there was something that I saw in JEI under Dungeon Tactics, and it was this Diamond Battle Axe. Look at that, 11.2 damage. Oh, fear me, I got the ban hammer. Mwahaha. Okay, so let me think. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and go into this. So basically you put the ore berries in there and we take our bucket and then we just hop. I know, you just stomp. Kinda stomp on this. And let's go ahead and fill up the tank so that we can get a couple buckets worth. Yeah, this takes up a little bit of hunger and it takes a little bit of effort. There's no way that I know of to automate it. Anyway, the tank is full. So we take the bucket, all right? And we got another quest. Okay. And that should be under Ironbound. Okay. So let's go ahead and claim that, get some more iron berries, and let's take a look at that. Drying basin and some dust. So we'll go ahead, pick one of these up, register the quest, detect. Come on. Okay, so let's go ahead, take that, place that down, and we fill these drying basins with the ore berries, and they will get dust. So this is how we're going to increase our supply of iron. So we'll go ahead and put more in there and just hop away. Okay, when we get to the grapes and the honey, I will show you a few things about brewing with Rustic because it's quite interesting. So let me go ahead and process this. Alright, that should be the last of it. And you see these little piles down there? If you right click with an empty hand, you get a small pile of tiny iron dust. Tiny pile of iron dust. So let's go over here, hit U, and you can either smelt it for nuggets, but can you craft it? Can you craft it into ingots? I'm wondering. No, you cannot. Okay, so let's go ahead, pop this in there. We'll grab some of you. Take this out, take that, and we can get some nuggets. Okay, and let's check out the status of our pulvis. We got our emerald and our diamond processed. Now, for the honey and the mead, we are going to need just 32 of each. We're going to need 32 grapes, 32 honeycomb, and we're going to need some bottles. So let's go ahead and grab one of these. We're going to need a boat ton of bottles for this. Okay, so how the wine brewing process works is basically we take our product that we want to brew. In this case, we'll go ahead and start with the grapes. All right, and then we smash them. It takes about 32 of these to make 8 buckets worth. Right now, we are making grape juice. So right now, this is not going to do much, but we are going to smoosh this down. Smoosh it down. Okay, so we got a full tub. Take that, take it in here, and we take just one bucket, and it's going to start fermenting, and it's going to come up with different qualities of wine. Let's take a look. That's elixir strength, bottle wine. You see how in JEI it says a quality of 0.75? We have to brew our wine to be at least above 0.5 in order for it to be of good quality. So we are going to do several batches of the wine to see if we get a good sample so that we can use it as a culture, so we can put it into this slot up here. But for now, we are just trying to just shoot in the dark just to try to get the best quality of wine that we can, because if you drink bad wine or bad mead, it will give you some bad effects. It can make you nauseated and it can give you dizziness. Well, the nauseated effect is kind of like dizziness. So we are just going to put one bucket of each to try to see what type of a brew do we get. So we're kind of just testing it out, getting the best quality that we can get out of these buckets. Now we're going to start with the honeycomb. So we got 32 of that, and then we're going to just mush it down, and this is going to make honey. And fermented honey is mead, and if you guys ever had mead, that is the best stuff in the world. Oh my goodness, that is so good. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and finish squishing everything down. Then we're going to take these barrels and place it in there for it to start fermenting. Okay, so we'll go ahead and place it into all of these barrels, one bucket each. Okay, so we are going to take care of that. All right, we're almost done. I'm gonna keep you along for this take. I'm not going to cut away. But this is how we make alcohol. Yeah, best stuff in the world. This is why I love Rustic, because it's not every day you get to brew alcohol products within Minecraft, you know? Because it's supposed to be, you know, kid friendly. But we got everything in there, so we'll just let that brew. Okay. And we're going to hit the sack. I'm gonna hit the sack because I don't want any mobs to come up. Okay, next, we're going to upgrade our armor. So, we're gonna go ahead and take that. Alright, take this, take that. And we'll go over here. Now, I think we just need 2 crafts of these cut diamonds. And we place 4 in the cardinal directions, and we place each piece of our armor so we get the jeweled armor set. Okay, so this should give us some better protection, and we got 2 cut diamonds. What do we use them for? Okay, we can upgrade our sword, but we got that hammer. But we can do a jeweled pickaxe. Interesting. Let's see. A ring? A diamond ring? Okay. We can craft it back. Okay. So, we got ourselves a supply of diamonds, a supply of emeralds. So, all we need to do is go ahead and put this away so that when we're ready to go on our journey, we can be fully armored. And it just looks so fabulous. Yes, it does. Okay, so we're going to chill for a little bit. Where's that clock? Where is that clock? Because I really like that clock. How long have we been on? We've been on for 4 hours. Wow. So we're going to go ahead and chill. Wait for these to ferment. And we're going to check on our results. So give me a moment. Okay, so it's been about 10 minutes. So let's see what our brew has come up for us. So let's take a look. 0.08. This is bad. This is bad. But we'll go ahead, take it and throw it away. This one. What's this one? Ooh, 0.74. Okay. That one is definitely a keeper. 0.11. Nope. We'll go ahead and throw you away. Okay. And let's see. What's this one? 0.65. Well, we got something better. We got something better. So we'll go ahead, hit that trash can to throw it away. We'll go ahead and take that out of our hand just in case. Let's see. 0.45. That won't do anything, but I will show you what happens if you drink bad wine. Oh, 0.4. That's even lower. Oh, wrong thing. Okay, so this is why you need the bottles. This is how you bottle your stuff. So let's see. That one's a 0.49, so that one's a no. Okay, and this one. 0.06. That is really horrible. That is really horrible. So we'll go ahead, click and delete that. All right, let's check our mead. All right, that is a 0.52. That's okay. Let's see if we get something better. 0.43. No. That is a negatory. Okay, let's check out this one. 0.25. That's even worse. All right, so there, it takes a little bit of patience to brew wine. Ooh, 0.73. We'll go ahead and throw you away and keep the 0.73. So we got 74 and 73. That is good. All right, let's see. Do we have something better? 0.39. Nope. That's a nope. All right, and this one, 0.3. No. Okay. So this is why we did just a little bit for a batch. All right, and this one is a 0.33. That one is nope. Okay, and this, 0.17, yuck. Just absolutely, totally yuck. All right, we're gonna go ahead and take this barrel and we're gonna take this mead and use it as a culture. Place it in there. Okay, so that's going to be our sample. And this one, the 0.74, we'll place it here as our culture. Okay, so let's go ahead and make ourselves another batch of wine. All right, and this time we have a guaranteed 0.74 quality for the wine and a 0.73 for the mead. So I will show you the results in a minute. You know, while we're waiting, I noticed this almanac from Rustic, and I'm actually kind of curious. I want to craft it. I want to see what this book is all about. What's this almanac? Agriculture, decoration, production. Alcoholic beverages. Oh, we can make it out of wild berries. We got lots of wild berry bushes. Ooh, and then apples too. I hadn't even thought about that. Okay. And then it says drinking booze with a quality of at least 0.5 will have a positive effect. Drinking with booze below a quality of 0.5 will have negative effects. Okay. That's interesting. I will definitely have to take a look at it. But let's check on our wine. So remember that our quality was 0.74. We filled up the whole entire barrel. So now we got a full barrel of 0.74 wine. So this is going to be some good stuff. And then our mead, we put in a quality of 0.73. Look at this. Our quality has increased to 0.76. So we got ourselves some good alcohol. And I bet you guys were wondering, what happens if you drink bad alcohol? So we're going to go ahead and drink this 0.45 quality of wine. Ooh, we got nausea. And if we take a look, yep, we got nausea. Yep. Whee! Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up here and build a more permanent wine setup. But until then, I hope you guys enjoyed yourself on this episode of Bounds. Don't mind the trippy effects. So anyway, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah. Ooh. Hick.